This right here is a Predator laptop I never thought I'd see. I mean, look at it. But here's the thing, I think it might be the future of gaming laptops. This is Luke with Digital Trends, and we are in the middle of the biggest tech week of the year, which is CES. So make sure you like this video and click subscribe so you can get all the content that we're putting out throughout this entire week. So this is the Predator Triton 300 SE, and if you just take a look at it on its surface, it's completely different than anything we've seen from the Acer Predator brand in the past. Obviously, it's a silver laptop instead of black or dark blue, and all of the big audacious branding that Predator usually puts on its laptops is completely gone in favor of a much more subdued look. But its size is really what makes this a special gaming laptop. It's one of the thinnest and lightest gaming laptops I've ever seen. It's only 0.7 inches thick and 3.75 pounds, which is almost a full pound lighter than the Razer Blade 15, just to put it in perspective. And that's already a really thin and light gaming laptop. Now from its front, it might not look too exciting. You might even mistake it for one of Acer's Aspire laptops, those budget laptops that are not particularly nice to look at. And even the big Predator logo has been reduced to just a small little badge in the corner of the lid. But there's a point to all this. As Acer explained to me, the Triton 300 SE is not just a gaming laptop. It's meant to do more than that. It's meant to be a laptop that you can do pretty much anything on, and that happens to include gaming. That's something new for the Predator brand, but it's not something we haven't seen before in gaming laptops. It's the same trend that companies like Razer and MSI have been chasing for years. But like I said up top, this really is in a new class, and that's primarily because of its size. This is a 14-inch screen, and that's a 1080p IPS 144Hz display, perfect for 1080p gaming, but really in a size category that has not been done, except for one other laptop, that is, which is the ASUS ROG Zephyrus G14. Now that thing came out last year, and I was singing the praises of that gaming laptop throughout 2020 because it was really the first laptop to break into this new category of thin and light gaming laptops in the 14-inch size. It was kind of incredible what they were able to pack into that. It has a super high-powered Ryzen processor and an RTX 2060. And now with the Triton 300 SE, we finally have an answer to that, but it comes from the Intel side instead of AMD. And that's where things get really interesting. Now, I can't actually test out the performance on this thing yet because this is just a first look, but let me at least tell you why I'm excited to eventually do that, because this thing has the very latest components from Intel and Nvidia, and both have a lot of potential for what this gaming laptop is trying to be. On the graphics front, we have the just announced brand new Nvidia RTX 3060. Nvidia says that these are going to be just as powerful as the RTX 2070 Super from the previous generation. And we won't know just how powerful that graphics card is until I can test it myself. But if we just take the Zephyrus G14 as a baseline, again, that had the RTX 2060, you could already play most games at 1080p, medium settings, at well over 60 frames per second, if not up close to that 144Hz for that fast refresh rate. Now, with the 3060, I'm expecting this thing to get even closer to that 144Hz for super fast, just responsive gaming in 1080p, and that's perfect for a laptop like this one. So as long as you're not trying to play Cyberpunk with all the ray tracing effects turned on, and even still, you know, I think we might be surprised about what this little laptop can do. And then there's the Intel side of things, which is also really exciting. This is the brand new, just announced, 11th gen Tiger Lake H series processors, but this is actually a special one. It's just a 35 watt processor. Most gaming laptops come in at that 45 watt slot. But the 35 watt option is what makes this 14 inch size possible. And it's a first for Intel, and it matches what AMD is doing on the Ryzen side of things. It's definitely true that if you go with a Ryzen 5000 laptop or even a previous gen Ryzen 4000 laptop, you're gonna get more cores, you're gonna get better multi-core performance. But when it comes to gaming, again, I think there's a lot of potential in this 35 watt Intel gaming laptop. Now, I don't love everything about this design. First off, gotta talk about the bezels because they're a little heftier than I'd like, especially along that bottom edge there. I'm also not in love with the keyboard. Acer has basically just ported over one of the Triton gaming laptop keyboards and put it on here. Kind of wish they'd done something new there because this is a little mushy for my taste. And then there's the build quality, which isn't horrible, but it is a little creaky in spots on the hinge, and there is some flex in the lid, which you never like to see when you're spending, you know, over $1,000 on a laptop, but it's nothing too egregious. But really, I'm kind of stunned by what Acer was able to bring to the table with the Triton 300 SE in partnership with Intel and Nvidia. If the gaming performance lives up to the potential here, I think we might have one of the most exciting new gaming laptops of 2021. It's certainly one of the most unique. What do you guys think of this new gaming laptop? 14 inches, does that make sense to you? Are you looking for something that's a little more subdued rather than really gamery? Let us know in the comments below, and make sure to subscribe for more videos from Digital Trends at CES, and thanks for watching.